What's going on, Doombots? Tony Scungili here with another team review, this time for the Inhumans. Now, the reason we're going to do the Inhumans is because a lot of people just got Black Bolt or just missed Black Bolt and are going to get him on the next pass. So I figure, why not talk a little bit about the team we'll be using with Black Bolt, or their completed team, the team you'd expect to see in Blitz or War, that kind of thing, and how to get the most value of them. Of course, if you've seen my reviews before, they're very simple. We discuss availability, usefulness, and breakpoints, investment levels that you would have to invest individually, including T4s, that would make the entire team better overall, as opposed to individual characters. But of course, I'll talk about individual characters too. So for right now, we'll do standard issue, generic auto blitz fight. So first, we're going to talk about availability, or honestly, lack thereof. While the characters are available in the game, they are probably the least available completed team that you can get to. Two of the characters, Quake and Crystal, are arena store characters. Now, they're not necessarily great in the early game, individually. Crystal's not even in arena yet at the time of this video. She will be added shortly. So they're not going to be high up on your priority list. Karnak is available at the very end of a Nexus farm, also incredibly far away from what most people would consider farmable, and all around not a phenomenal character in and of his own accord, so you're probably not going to be getting too much Karnak early, middle, or even the beginning of the end game for you. Yo-Yo is unfarmable in the game. The only way you can get her is by spending money or premium luck. So, by all accounts, she's just inaccessible. You can buy her or you don't get her. And that's a huge downfall when it comes to building a team. It doubles down as she is one of the best individual members on the team, next to, of course, Black Bolt. And even without Black Bolt, she stands alone as one of the best protectors in the game. So, unfortunate that they made it so that Yo-Yo is not very accessible in the game, but what do you expect from Fox next? The last character, of course, is Black Bolt. He is legendary. He requires an entire team of five other characters to get. We've already covered them. That would be the Asgardians. So overall, availability on a scale of 1 to 10, it's like a 2. Sure, some of the characters are available early. Sure, some of the characters are available reasonably. But one of them is a legendary unlock. One of them is completely unfarmable in the game. And two of them are in the same store, making it very, very difficult to target down one of them. So they are not quite available. That said, the only characters that you would normally need outside of the entire team are, of course, Black Bolt and Yo-Yo. So if you were to get lucky or decide to spend money on one or the other, once you have those two characters, you don't quite need to invest in characters like Quake, Karnak, or Crystal until much later. Or maybe by the time you would invest in those characters, the rest of the Inhumans like Medusa and Gorgon might come out, making some of them a little bit less valuable than others, or kind of displacing them. But as of right now, they're not too available. Now let's take a quick look at how useful the team can be. And before we go directly into the usefulness, I'm going to just address something. While there is another character with the Inhuman tag, she has absolutely no synergy with any of the other characters. That would be Ms. Marvel. So we're not including her because a character has a tag, like off the top of my head, Killmonger is a mercenary, doesn't necessarily mean you would build a mercenary team with him right now. It does mean that you'd probably keep him as a Wakandan, as that's kind of where his home is. Same kind of thing goes for Ms. Marvel. Ms. Marvel is a hero brawler. She's the leader of the hero brawler team, more or less. So putting her on the Inhumans, with the exception of using for an event that requires specifically Inhuman characters, you wouldn't necessarily try. She doesn't help the team. She's just a character who happens to be there. So as for usability, the entire team, Quake, Crystal, Karnak, Yo-Yo, and Black Bolt, doesn't have much use. And when I say that, I mean, they're not going to do something for you that a easier to access team couldn't do for less investment. And I know that sounds crazy, but if you think about it, you have to bring up an entire team in order to get Black Bolt, and then bring up his entire team And by the time you've done that, you've the team you use for Black Bolt might be better at what you're trying to do. Now, most of these characters are bio, with the exception of Karnak, who is depressing, but you can use them in beta, you know, as any bio-specific characters. You don't have to. They're not quite a raid team. They can definitely beat up a node, and of course, Black Bolt and Yo-Yo as a two-piece are absolutely phenomenal in any raid where you can put them together, even in Dark Dimension, if you can. Overall, not really. As far as how usable they are as a team, they don't mesh very well. Now, that might be because they're incomplete, because Fox Next really enjoys releasing almost complete teams like the Symbiotes or Marauders or the Fantastic Four-ish, that kind of thing. The Defenders technically only have four. You know, they really like this four-person team, even though it's pretty obvious who the fifth should be throughout the time that the team kind of plays out. Power Armor 2, obviously with Vision, and now they're adding the fifth Power Armor character. I do enjoy that, but I do like when a team does what it's supposed to do. And as for the Inhumans, they're a war team. That's it. And I don't know if you guys watch my stream or seen any of my videos, but just being a war team doesn't really matter to me. It's kind of lazy, if you ask me. A team that's just good at war. Now, that might be good enough. You know, we have 130 or so characters available in the game right now, and because Quake, Crystal, and Karnak supplement Yo-Yo and Black Bolt very well, they're good enough to be a war offense team or a blitz team, which help, right? But all in all, they're not particularly good at raids, or you don't really need them for arena. Now, the whole team, obviously. I've seen a lot of Yo-Yo Black Bolt. Sometimes I see Crystal. I never see Karnak, and Quake hasn't been in the arena since 2018. So when you talk about usability, we unfortunately don't get to look at the entirety of the Inhumans team because they really don't have many uses. That said, Black Bolt and Yo-Yo specifically have some of the most useful kits in the game right now. Yo-Yo and Black Bolt alone can probably carry most players through the top 60% of U7. Any node that requires bio characters, no issues. You can't use them both on a cosmic or global node, as Black Bolt's cosmic and Yo-Yo's global, but anytime you could use them for any of those situations, you should be okay. Black Bolt stands on his own, Yo-Yo stands on their own, but if you can use them together, absolutely great. So it's unfortunate that when we look at the entire Inhumans team, we really have to focus in on just the two characters. And you can even see from my investment, while I probably could invest more in Quake, Karnak, and Crystal, I don't really have to, because for all of my uses, Yo-Yo and Black Bolt alone, they're my U7 team. They're my warfight. And actually, I have a warfight right here to show you them beating up Hydra. And actually, I do have a war fight recorded for you just to kind of play you out at the end of the video. But usefulness, the whole team, not much. Black Bolt and Yo-Yo, incredibly. And even then, as a result of how good Black Bolt and Yo-Yo are, it costs so much to make sure Quake, Crystal, and Karnak are comparable, if that makes sense, that I wouldn't say skip it, but don't prioritize the Inhumans at any point in the time. Their usability as a team is not there. Which will lead us to our last step, breakpoints. Now, as you heard before, I like to do breakpoints in about 50k intervals. So how low level your Inhumans team is, considering the fact that they are an endgame team, it's unlikely that you would start them at about 50k. It's unlikely you would have an Inhumans team that was incapable of getting to at least 100k relatively quickly, let alone 150. So at about 30k each, they are an adequate team for war and for blitz. They should probably be okay at winning as long as they're roughly in parity. The biggest issue becomes if you have outscaled Black Bolt and Yo-Yo to the rest of the team, your blitz fights become a little bit less reliable because Black Bolt and Yo-Yo are making two of your opponents really strong and the rest of them really don't do a lot of work. Going directly into tier fours, Karnak technically level five on this will help him really iron in the fact that he desperately needs more focus in order to get what he needs. It goes from a total of 20% extra focus to 40% extra focus. It's huge. It's also kind of a nice ability for it to flip random effects on the turn, but it kind of works like other ones where if they don't have a positive effect, doesn't flip anything, but if you invest in it, he does place defense down. Kind of helps a little bit in war, not highest priority, and pressure points is probably the most important one. But let's be clear, if plus 50,000 extra focus isn't enough to clear all the positive effects and apply debuff, is plus 100,000 much more? You know, it adds a little damage, which is great, but he's not really big at damage, so I don't know. It seems to me that if he needs 100,000 extra focus to do what he needs to do on this attack, something else went wrong somewhere. And of course, that's, you know, JJ has so much focus when she uses her ult. If he needs that much more to do kind of the same thing, I'm not sure that's worth it. Crippling Blows is a little bit of a fun investment. You can lower the speed bar a little, and that's the first time it adds that text. So that's a very useful ability, but it's not necessarily a part of what he needs to be good. Most of the time, this is, like I said, a war offense team. So you should be winning on the back of the strength of your Black Bolt and your Yo-Yo in general. If you do plan on using him defensively or putting the Inhumans on defense, this is probably the investment you're looking at. And damage with damage, no big deal on that. Moving to Crystal, kind of the biggest and most important thing is her passive, making sure she's clearing negative effects and giving heals whenever an Inhuman drops down. But it is only one time, and it is only if they're at full health at the start of the match, making her a little bit less valuable in war defense or in raids, but more valuable on offense, obviously. Everything else is just damage, but it is a lot of damage. So as she is not obviously as good as Black Bolt at damage, but for the team, relatively okay, you can treat her as if her investments in damage matter, but ultimately none of her abilities truly require tier fours. She's just generic damage dealer on the team, except second wind, which gives them a little bit more survivability. Quake, this gets a little strange. She has pretty good focus on the completed team, so plus 5% extra focus, not really doing much. Earthquake just adds damage, no notes. Shockwave, if Coulson or Yo-Yo is an ally, apply slow. This triggers on her special, which kind of helps the team overall, but again, you don't need tier fours in it. It's just more damage. And Seismic Blast, again, just more damage. She doesn't do as much damage as Crystal, so she's kind of the third damage dealer on the team. And that's, you don't really ever need to work on the third damage dealer on the team. So Quake hasn't needed tier fours since tier fours came out, so nothing really changed there. Yo-Yo is a little bit different. So Swift Protector increases the amount of focus she has per non-minion Inhuman ally. That's great if it's just her and Black Bolt. It's great if it's her on the full Inhumans team. It's great if it's her with, you know, Nick Fury for some reason or another. The dodge chance goes from 15 to 25 with the investment. So for me, it was a little bit worth it. Her focus could use a little bit of a bump, so I wanted to make sure I had it. Getting those offense downs to stick is the most important part of her protector version of her kit. So it was absolutely worth it just to get a little bit more, providing I have at least one other Inhuman or non-minion shield character on the team. Everything else is pretty much done at level 4 anyway. Dodge chance is okay. As for the Run the Gauntlet and Flurry, just damage. She doesn't do much damage to begin with. She just is very fast. Repeat the attack on all three additional random targets. Again, more damage. This is a little bit better than normal damage because it hits again. So, okay, but you don't really need damage. And rapid strikes, this is different. So, this is strange. You want this when she's paired with Black Bolt, because that means every time she basics, not only does it do damage and clear counter, it says a random Inhuman, but if it's only Black Bolt there, Black Bolt also does a ton of damage and clears more buffs. So on characters like Juggernaut or Colossus, since they have pretty decent focus between the two of them, there's a chance that by the time they're done, they've ripped 3-4 buffs off the character and did a ton of damage on basic. So it gets a little bit worse when you're not calling Black Bolt, but depending on how well your investment is, an extra attack or an assist is always better. It's just better for like U7 duo team than it is anything else, but that's why I have that investment. And Black Bolt is one of the best damage dealers in the game. There's no reason not to invest in all of his abilities, as they all increase his damage. King of Adalan increases the amount of damage his cough does. Doubles increases the amount of damage it does to Ultron and Nebula, and increases the maximum health for himself and all Inhuman allies. 50% max health for himself and all Inhuman allies. That's a lot. That's a ton of max health, which makes him so important to his team that without Black Bolt, you can't have an Inhumans team. There is no version of the Inhumans that doesn't have Black Bolt. They don't work well together. They need his kit, aside from the resistance, obviously. The rest of his attacks, like I said, it is just damage, but man, is it a lot of damage. The last investment is 120% extra damage on attack. Staggering Voice brings an extra 100 or a total 600 damage, one of the highest single target damage attacks in the game, close to characters like Thing, or that's it, pretty much. Thing, Ultron's ultimate, they're all in the same kind of conversation. And Royal Strike, this is the one you don't actually have to invest in all the time. It goes from clearing one or two positive effects to one. If the primary target has slow, flip two negative effects on self. That's one of the reasons why using him with Scientist Supreme or Graviton tends to come up a lot in U7. That slow effect to turn debuffs into buffs really makes him ridiculous. The fact that it's a huge damage attack on a basic, the fact that you can get it to assist when you're called by Yo-Yo, and the fact that it clears two positive effects. Yeah, you're never going to regret a single tier 4 you put into Black Bolt. You don't have to put all of them in. Just remember, they're all damage related. As long as King of Adalan is done, you should be okay. Everything else is basically just how much more damage do you want to do. By all means, go for it. And that's Breakpoint tier 4 is pretty much it. I will say, though, overall, while I do like to recommend teams be brought up together, because this team is somewhat incomplete, as we don't have Medusa and Gorgon or Gorgon yet, or any other of the Royal Family characters they intend on bringing in, and because they're not phenomenal together, I wouldn't necessarily worry too much about balancing this team out at a break point. If you're investing only in two characters, and I don't care if you only have a 2-star Yo-Yo, Yo-Yo is a phenomenal character. Black Bolt at 5 with no reds is just as good. He will do something for you. The more red stars, the more stars you have, obviously, the stronger they'll be. They might be able to do things quicker or more reliably, but overall, that's fine. That said, Quake, Crystal, and Karnak, they don't have that same appeal. They all contribute to what this team is trying to do, but ultimately, if all of their ability kits were take a turn, give my turn meter to Black Bolt so he took more turns, you would probably have a better series of events, because that's how good Black Bolt is. So I would say if you can bring this team up to about 150k or 30k each character, At that point, you can feel free to invest exclusively in characters like Black Bolt and Yo-Yo, bring them up with gear and level, etc. Without worrying too much about Quake, Crystal, and Karnak. You only really would have to invest in them specifically if you're noticing your war fights aren't going the way you want, or if you want to place a big dumb Inhumans team on war defense and say, fight me. Those are good options. But after 150k, any investment you put in Quake, Crystal, and Karnak tends to not feel as important as the investments you place in characters like Black Bolt and Yo-Yo. That might be because we don't have an Inhumans tagged anything right now. If they rework some of the Greek raids, we may have to revisit this conversation. They may become slightly better, or you know, all four of them instead of the entire five might be part of one of the better teams, plus, you know, one dedicated healer like a Minerva or a Shuri. Either way, we can address that when it comes. As for right now, because Black Bolt and Yo-Yo are so good, and Quake, Crystal, and Karnak are medium to low value on their own, let alone the fact that you don't need any of them with just Yo-Yo and Black Bolt. As a matter of fact, even Crystal is slightly detrimental. There's probably a better option somewhere besides her. I would say, unfortunately, this is probably a B team. They do have very specific things they answer, in the exact same way that the Wakandans can answer very specific things, or the Defenders can answer very specific things. Having a very specific answer is good now, but it doesn't necessarily show longevity or value over time. Let's use Hydra as an example, and we're going to get to that. I'm going to play out in this video a fight where my Inhumans are beating up a Hydra team. Now, granted, it's a punch down, but doesn't matter. I've seen a lot of people not be able to punch down against Hydra anyway, so just to show they can beat Hydra, but as the people test more and more, you're finding out there are more teams that can beat Hydra. So their ability for them to beat one team in war, okay, as an entire team, the reason I say it's B tier is Black Bolt and Yo-Yo are probably more reliable if you don't have three other Inhumans on the team than if you do, because of how Yo-Yo and Black Bolt's interactions on assists work. But overall, they're just not a great team. They have individual value. They might be a little bit hard to beat. You may see Black Bolt, Yo-Yo, and Crystal on arena defense featuring Phoenix and Ultron, or Phoenix and Colossus, or Sinister, or however people want to break it down, but ultimately that's temporary. And with the new Black Order team coming out, it's probably not going to be that likely to succeed going forward. So, yeah, unfortunate. One of the best characters in the game, and probably arguably the best damage dealer in the game, being Yo-Yo and Black Bolt respectively, are so good that they can't necessarily bring up the value of Quake, Karnak, and Crystal. B-tier team, as their only real value is war. And a team that's only good at war isn't good for much. That said, thank you guys so much for watching. Comment below, let me know if you just got Black Bolt, or if you're using the team, or if you're enjoying them, if you found something I couldn't. If Karnak is actually secretly good and no one knew about it, because how would they? Comment below and let me know. Other than that, have a good night, have a great day. I've been Tony Scungili, and I'll catch you later.